earthquake in Peru. So we knew there was a need to help rebuild houses. So we had sent a team of youth and adults down, I believe 3 years ago, and they helped to construct walls and eventually build roofs on the houses. So I think they built 4 houses. And it was through that we got to know Pastor Martin. So then Pastor Martin and Cody have been up here, and it's just been a great relationship of working together. And I see our relationship with El Shaddai as kind of a symbiotic relationship where we help them and they help us and they inspire us, and hopefully we're able to inspire them a little bit also.
Planning of the event, when we started planning probably close to a year before, we knew we wanted to return to Ica, Peru, that we wanted as leaders to return, but we wanted to share that with the students now that are in senior high. And what a joy it was to work alongside of all of them, just watching their heart for God, for morning devotions when they would, we'd give them an extra half hour and they would get out their Bibles and journals and spend time in the Word before we ever started the day. And their, you know, participation throughout the entire trip, so many times. I think everything we did, they wanted to do twice. And that is such a reward to me, knowing that they enjoyed Ica and Peru as much as I do. And God really blessed the trip and the enjoyment that everyone had there.
Had a couple teams go down. We've got a great relationship with the El Shaddai Church and with Pastor Martin and Cody, so it's kind of a dream of mine that we could send another team down. So those of us who are here will be praying for you guys.
Separated, I cut myself clean from a past that comes back. My darkest of dreams, been apprehended by a spiritual force and the grace that replaced all the me I give up. Truth. Kamikaze, my death is gain. I've been marked by my maker, peculiar display. The high and lofty, they see me as weak.
Basically, you know you're in a different country when the thing on top is in a not English.
Thank you. talk about how this trip allowed you to fulfill your duty as a Christian?
It was a great opportunity for us to fulfill like what the Lord says in Matthew 25. You know, whatever you do, the least of these, you've done to me. And it's important to do works for the Lord to build the kingdom, to build His reign.
Does it matter if we're rich or we're poor? Fortune and fame, they never endure. Oh, love is the thing. Love is the thing. What good is money if your heart isn't light? Here in your arms, I'm wealthy tonight. When youth has its fling, love is a thing. While others fight for power, we can walk among the flowers, knowing that the best thing in life is the thing that's free. Love for you and me. And even though our castles crumble and fall, we have the right.
My favorite memory from the trip was probably going to the village and playing with little kids and stuff. They were really cute. And this one little girl, what was her name? Her name was Stephanie. We would write each other's names into the chalk. And she was introducing me to all her friends. So that was my favorite part.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your love makes me sing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, your love makes me sing, hallelujah.
The worship at El Shaddai was really, really energetic, and it was a lot of fun, and everyone there just got so into it and didn't care what people around them were like, talking about. And it was just really insightful. It just made me realize that it really doesn't matter what it looks like to anybody else.
Tu amor es sorprendente, total y diferente, que va en aumento muy dentro de mí. Y cuando estoy contigo, tu bondad me lleva, siento que un canto se levanta en mí. Aleluya, aleluya, aleluya. Como me hace cantar, aleluya.
What I liked about El Shaddai was how much energy the people put into worshiping God. And how much energy Pastor Martin put into preaching. just watching Pastor Martin speak, shouting out, getting on the ground on his knees. Yeah, really impacted me and makes me want to bring that back.
If you are two women, las dos necesitan casarse,
and you both need to
se acerca de rodillas,
you get down on your knees,
se ponen chapitas,
you put
de rodillas,
you get on
your knees, señor,
and pray,
love me, esposo,
bring my husband,
no necesito,
I need
urgente, me estoy quemando,
hey, bring him.
Y si se ponen de acuerdo, Dios responderá.
And you put yourself in agreement together, God will answer.
Porque dice si se ponen de acuerdo.
Because the Bible says, don't put it together. Two people. God will respond.
Nancy and Augusto are the house parents there. They have two children of their own, and they have 40 boys living in the house complex with them, and they are the main parents. They go grocery shopping together, they go to church together. Really, it's a loving household that the boys' home is.
At the boys' home, we came for lunch, but it was a lot more than that. We went and spent time with a lot of the boys there. They were like ranged from like 8 to, or like a little bit younger than 8, like 6 to my age, which is like 16. 18, I lied. And we just hung out with them, and they're really interested in like music and everything. And we sat by boys our age at the table where we were eating lunch at, and we started like a conversation, and it was amazing how we could understand them so well. And we talked about like favorite music and hobbies and everything, and they ended up like singing with us, and we played tunes on their guitar, and we all just hung out and had fun. And we also played like sports and soccer and drew chalk with them, and it was a lot of fun.
So sweet the surrender.
Able to play with skilled players and in a professional setting was a really great time for me, one of my favorite parts of the trip.
Highlights were playing soccer with the Peruvians, even though we got our butt
across my TV screen. At the work site, the students participated in the groundbreaking for an auditorium. It will be the first building, other than they have put bathroom facilities there, this is the first actual building that they're putting on the site. It will hold worship service for all of the congregation at El Shaddai, which currently is held in a rented building. They hold 4 services a day. So with the building of this auditorium, they'll be able to have one service and just bring the church together as a community.
Favorite part of the trip? Well, I'd say it was definitely probably out on the work site. I would say just watching how hard all the kids were working and being able to work alongside of the youth. That would be my highlight.
I'll abandon every selfish thought.
Do you guys want to tell me about your day?
So it was really hard, you know, working in the cold all day, pooping.
Yeah.
And yeah, my arms are kind of jello.
Yeah.
But it was fun. Everything I'm not, I am willing, I'm not afraid. But I feel pretty encouraged. I feel like we did a lot. Like, I feel good at the end of the day. I want to be your hands. I want to be your feet.
Galatians 6:9. Let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. 10. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all people, especially those who belong to the family of believers.
Together. Took a little bit to figure out what was going on and what work needed to be done, but once we figured out what we were doing, it wasn't a problem.
You guys are incredibly hard workers. You know, just enjoy that we have fun together, but at the same time, we got a lot done.
How do you like pouring concrete?
Awesome.
Yeah.
My name is Julio Castillo.
I just want to thank you for being such a leader to us this week.
No, no tanto, pero le agradezco también a ustedes porque entendieron el trabajo, lo hicieron bien. Y lo felicito, aprendieron bastante y apoyaron mucho, muchísimo apoyado.
He said it's not him, he said that we caught on really fast and we're really good learners and workers and it's been a blessing to work with us.
Would you tell me how could it be any better than we'll be right back.
The food was really good. Lots and lots of good food.
Welcome to the planet. Welcome to existence.
Hebrews 10:25. Let us not give up meeting together, as some are in the habit of doing, but let us encourage one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching.
Everybody's watching you now. Everybody waits for you now. What happens next?
And what was your favorite memory or moment from the trip? Building the relationships with the people who were on the trip and the people who live in Peru was really cool experience, and getting to interact with someone not necessarily from my culture or who speaks my language.
That was Mercedes. She is just fun.
Welcome to the farm.
This is amazing.
It was a really good opportunity for a lot of the team members to get new friendships, get new connections, and really build bonds that necessarily weren't there.
How was coming home after the long work days for you and for everyone else?
It was tiring. We all just fell asleep when we got back from lunch. But we were happy that we accomplished a lot of stuff, and we're happy that we finished what we wanted to do that day.
I think the way I saw God move was in the relationships that were built and formed within the group that, and the youth and the adults that went down there, but also between the group and the people of Peru. There was a lot of friendships and bonds that were made, and I think that was really, really, really neat.
Was the Peru missions trip really freaking awesome? Did David Betts eat a lot of rice?
Good. Where are you right now?
I don't know. I'm in the middle of this there. Somehow. Not on a boat.
Really freaking awesome.
What impacted you the most on the Peru trip?
I guess it's kind of cliche, but like the how people were so grateful for such little that they had, like, I don't know, like at their floor and stuff, a lot of people would be freaking out and everything, but it was just really awesome. Like, I don't know, it doesn't take much to make them happy, and I think it's a really good quality to have.
How did I feel God's presence? I think the Holy Spirit presence was just overwhelming to me as I saw the group just work in peace and joy together. Just everything seemed to be so easy for me as a leader, and I know Pastor Derek thought the same, that the trip just went so easy, that there were difficult times, there were many challenges, but we just came together as a group and just forged right through. If it was digging holes, and we were digging huge 4 foot, probably by 4 foot holes, 4 foot, 4 foot deep, and if we dug too many, so we dug them at the wrong place, we would just start digging another, and no one complained. They just worked to the day's end.
Okay, guys, they said they changed plans. They wanted to come over here and work on these ones.
Wait, we're not finishing these?
I guess not right now. They said, first of all, we all need to go over here.
What?
I don't know.
Okay.
And at the end of the day, it's like, let's go get rested up for tomorrow. And they came back at it, you know, with lots of energy and excitement for their service project down there. It's all God's children singing
glory, glory, hallelujah. We as a whole youth group just want to thank you for leading us and taking us.
No, it's my pleasure, man. It was a blessing.
I was just thrilled to be a part of it. Like I said, I would have loved to have gone. It just didn't seem to work out this time. Hopefully the next time. And I'm just excited at having, especially the students, having the cross-cultural experience and just seeing what God's doing in a larger part of the earth, and also caring and connecting with kids, like at the orphanage and at the church. I just think it's a wonderful experience to have that kind of cross-cultural connection and relationship.
What is your outlook on missions trips?
I think they're really great. I think they're a great way to spread not only the gospel, but spread the work that has to be done, kingdom work, better the kingdom, to build the kingdom of the Lord in a setting and in a environment that is fun, that you can do fun things, that you can do new things in a different country is always great. And you can, it's a great experience. You can experience the world, and you can do a kingdom work. So two great things at once. And that's what I really love about Christian Fellowship. Yes, I am. I'm very glad I went. Wouldn't have traded it for anything. He reigns. All God's children singing glory.